Today is the day. It's our 30th anniversary, and we are celebrating big. This morning, we salute our behind-the-scenes team that work tirelessly to get the show on the air each and every day.
We are so grateful for them all, and we couldn't do it without them. You hear us talking about our producers all the time, Claudine, Roxanne, our executive producer, Marcus. Well, guess what? Now you finally get to meet them. Take a look.
Hey, Kurt, just a heads up, we're going to be tight on time, so you have a minute 30 here.
Can we launch the chopper back to South
LA? We have breaking news.
I'm Claudine. I have been at KTLA for 12 years, and I am the line producer for the 7 and 8 a.m. hours.
I'm Roxanne Cox. I produce the morning show. I started off doing the 7 and 8. Now I do the 9 and 10, because I get to sleep in until 3 o'clock in the morning now.
My name is Marcus Smith. I've been here at KTLA for 11 years, a part of the morning news for 2 years. And I'm the executive producer.
The question is, will it break on our show or a later show?
Well, this is to be determined by Marcus himself, as all things.
Part of the reason why I wanted to intern here was because of Mark Kriski, Sam Rubin, Gail Anderson. I actually grew up watching KTLA.
Mark Kriski used to be like a DJ at K-Big or something, and he actually was like, you should come down to KTLA and intern. So I came down, got an internship, immediately loved it, knew I needed to be on the morning show, work in some capacity on the morning show. And I just stuck with it, and I've kind of grown up here. I've literally grown up here. I think I've been here since I was 19 years old.
Producer Roxanne, who we love. Happy birthday, Roxanne. Photo here. Her movie husband, Jason Momoa, who she chased down. This is our lot, our KTLA lot that we share with Netflix.
That's her Christmas card. Forget the kids and Bobby. It's her and Jason.
We are a family. A bizarre family in some ways.
Marcus said we definitely don't.
Executive producer Marcus said we definitely don't.
Oh, of all the things I bring up, dog farting is off limits. Okay.
The KTLA Morning News is one of a kind. You see things on our station that you won't see anywhere else.
My goal every morning is to put together a show that is informative, filled with facts, and also filled with some fun. It's the morning, and that's what people want. They want to see the weather, they want to see traffic, they want the news that they need to get out the door, and then they also want to laugh to start their day off.
Later, advice from Mark Kriski himself.
Oh, boy. I don't know if you want to take the advice.
Okay.
Just because I dispense it doesn't mean you have to take it.
When I come in every morning, my goal for the show is to do the stories that people are talking about that morning. But honestly, I feel like you're going to get that on a lot of other shows. But I think people come to KTLA specifically for the talent. And they want to see what those people have to say about the stories that people are talking about all day long.
This breaking news and probably the most important story of the day.
Oh.
Mid-June, Costco is going to bring back the food samples.
We've been doing that story all morning.
Oops.
And back to you.
This show would not go on every morning without each and every person in our newsroom. We have the overnight assignment desk. Alberto is there, and usually it's Nancy as his assistant.
I love Alberto. I mean, he's like the nucleus.
They help us get the reporters out the door. Our news center guys are always making sure that we have all of the live shots done, that they have the reporters ready to go. Our writers, we wouldn't have a show without them. They are the ones who write the write their stories and also edit a lot of the video that you see at home. Our reporters, our photographers, they're the ones heading out the door every morning. They're trying to get you the latest facts from whatever scene that they're at. They're trying to get you the reaction from people. And then the directors, every morning, you have to work with them to bring your concept to life. I can make lines in a rundown, but if it's not them pushing the buttons and making sure that everything looks right, it's all going to look sloppy.
You know, when you think of a news producer who's in your ear, and we have breaking news and we have things changing or mistakes are made, and sweet Claudine, God love her, she is just calm. She's patient.
She's a young woman who came to us, I think, as an intern and has developed these incredible skills, who practically reads my mind every morning. Sometimes I'll be saying to her, I think that, and she'll say, you mean story such and such? Yes, I'm already working on it. Roxanne is our producer, who produces the 9 to 11 a.m. hours, and she's been with us for years. and is not just an amazing producer, but an amazing wife and mother. And I don't know how she does it all, but she keeps it all in the air, and she is laser focused to make sure that her programs every day are the best they can be.
Things she says in our earpiece would make a sailor blush. She doesn't mince words, and we love Roxanne for that. Marcus is our executive producer, and Marcus is, he's just sweet. Marcus just smiles at you, and you're like, you know what, it's all gonna be okay when Marcus smiles at you like that.
He cares deeply about what we do. He cares deeply about you, the home viewer, and I couldn't be more proud to work with him every day.
It's a great feeling to wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning and know that I'm the executive producer of the KTLA Morning News. You know, this show started when I was a kid dreaming about being on the news.
I'm super grateful for this job. I love what I do, and like I said, I just love the people here.
I feel so blessed to get to work here and to do what I do and to be part of Los Angeles.
Oh, we love our producers.
Love those people.
So much.
Yes.
I mean, they have the patience of a saint. What they do every day, we love them. Couldn't do it without.
And they're so talented.
All of them.
And you have no idea how many moving parts there are here, and they just keep it going. It's
And Roxanne doesn't really curse like a saint.
Yes, she does, actually. she absolutely does.
No, but we love them, and we're friends, so we could say that about each other, but they're the best.
And
the best of the best.
Happy birthday to Marcus.
And happy birthday to Marcus. He won't tell us how old he is, but we know he's been working here and been watching the show since he's a kid.
Well, so. Like me.
Like
and,
you.
And you.
Exactly.
So,
exactly. We're all around the same.
Nice. Thank you, guys.
That was awesome.
Love you all.